Guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will be talking about how to set up creative grid for Power App. So Microsoft Power Cat team and community have created a toolkit called Creator Kit for Power Apps. You may simply design uniform, lovely, and effective user experiences for a unique business app with its assistants. By adopting these controls, you can have a stunning, authentic Microsoft user experience, because all the controls are built on using FluentUI framework, which is used in all Microsoft applications. So to install Creator Kit, you can go to the link. So this is the link you need to go. And if you click on it, it'll open this page. And you can see the description of the Creator Kit over here. Below here, you can see download Creator Kit button, and then there are other two reference app solutions, Creator App and Custom Pages. You need to download all of these three. So I have already downloaded it, but just to show you, I can click on it and it'll download. But once you've downloaded it, you need to go to make.powerapps.com. Now, from the Power Apps Maker portal, you need to go to solution. From the solution, you need to go to import solution, and then browse, and then import the Creator Kit core, which is this one. I have downloaded all three. You need to import it one by one. You cannot do it in parallel. So first I will go with Creator Kit core and go to next. And then import it. So you can wait for till this solution is imported, and once this is done, you will go with another solution. Now that my solution is imported, let's go inside and see its component. So you can see that there are several components included in solution, like auto with label, breadcrumb, calendar, command bar, context menu, elevation, face pie. So all these components can be used in your Power Apps now. So the Creator app also has some reference app which can be downloaded in the main page, whose link can be seen here. And these solution needs to be also imported into your environment. So since I have already downloaded, I will go back to my make.powermaker portal and import it to my solution. So I will click import. First, I will import the canvas reference creator kit. And you need to follow the same process for importing the app into your environment. So this will take some time. Once this is done, we will go to another Creator Kit references for MDA. Now that Creator Kit references for Canvas is imported, we will be importing Creator Kit references MDA and import this solution as well. Now your Creator Kit references MDA has been imported as well. So let's go inside Creator Kit MDA. And you can see that the components have been imported. If you go to apps, you will see that there is a Creator Kit reference app, and you can open it. Oh, sorry, you need to play it. So over here, I'll play this. And this is a really cool app which where we can see best practices for using controls, as well as you can get sample codes. So let's go to, for say, let's go to command bar. So you can see the do's and don'ts that you need to implement while using command bar, as well as sample code samples. So let's allow it. So you see, everything that you need is over there, and in the code, you can see the sample code for this. So now let's go to my solution again, and let's go back. So I will create a new solution and I will call it just demo. So we can use a Canvas app template for start building the new app, which is also present in the Creator Kit. You can go to Add Existing and go to Canvas app. And there is a template, Canvas template, which we can use to start creating, quickly create Fluent UI based application, which comes with custom components preloaded. But before opening this app, we need to enable the custom components through our admin center. So for that, I will go to my admin center, which you can go to from the left setting option. Click on admin center. And from the admin center, we need to turn on the component-based settings. So I'll go to my environments and I have my environment is Sumit. So this is my environment. And from here, I will go to my settings, then product and features. On my right side, I need to check for Power Apps component framework for the Canvas app. So I need to allow it and then go down and save it. So I can start building an app through by copying this template. For that, I need to go to edit. You can start building app from here, but before that you need to copy this so that you don't mess up with the template. So I'll just call it copy and save back, and you can see that there are a bunch of components that are already added and you can start building your app from this. So I'll go back to my solution. It's already in my solution. So I can add, remove the original template that was from the CAD template. I can remove it and I can start building apps from it. You can use this template or you can directly create an app as well. So if you don't want to use template, you want to build something from scratch, you just go to new, go to app and create a Canvas app. Let's call it a demo app for create a kid and click create. So if you go to this insert sign, you can see that you can, there is an option called get more components. When you click on it, you can see the Power Apps CAD component library. For example, I want a dialogue, so I can click on it and import it. And once you import it, it will show up in this option of your insert. So in the library components, the particular component that I imported is there. So this is the dialog box, which is pre-built by Power Apps CAD team. When I, so I'm inserting it and then I can use its properties like title. I can use its subtitle to change it. Let's say my custom dialog, sorry, custom dialog. And then whatever subtitle you want to put it. And as I mentioned, the documentation for this is, everything is mentioned here. So for dialogue, you can see all the information that you need about how to use this dialogue, how to use this layout, how to use its context, content, as well as its code. Is everything is present here. Apart from just this dialogue, there are other also components which I can click on get more components, Power Apps component again, and then I can insert other whatever components that I need. If it's a search bar, I can import it. So search box is imported. So this is how you can do it. And if you want more components, code-based components, it's also present here. So there is, let's say I want a resizable text area. I can import it, and it will, again, there will be other section called code component from here. I can